We have to be very careful because the layer that separates those two aquifers is a layer that can compact, it can cause ground sinking, and it's something that we do need to be monitoring.
Lee County's largest city is getting the attention of researchers overseas. Scientists from the Geological Survey of Norway, who look at sinking patterns around the world, found that parts of Cape Coral are sinking.
And local experts agree the Cape is sinking. But as NBC2's Zuri Hoffman explains, not everyone agrees on what exactly is causing it.
Nearly everywhere you look in Cape Coral, you can tell the city is growing and fast, with more construction and even more residents. According to the latest census data, it's now home to more than 200,000 people, up nearly 11% from data taken in 2020. That growth drawing the attention of researchers overseas who believe the influx, along with the city's water use, could be contributing to parts of the Cape sinking.
We really need to be careful before we point fingers because we don't really have all the information yet.
We took that study from the Science of Remote Sensing to local experts here at FGCU. Rachel Rotz, a groundwater hydrologist, says these researchers use sophisticated technology over a seven-year period, detecting some areas are sinking. The issue she has is conclusively connecting the sinking to the city's water treatment plants.
This team identified some subsidence in North Cape Coral, and it happens to be the location of the reverse osmosis water plant.
Those RO plants is how the city cleans its water. It operates similar to a pool filter, getting rid of things like sand and sediment. The city operates a number of them.
I would put confidence in the conclusion that the ground is sinking in Cape Coral. So I'm not saying it's not, and I actually think, you know, based on what I know about that technique, it's probably accurate. The measurement of how much it's sinking, I'm not as confident in. I think that needs to be verified by an additional data set. However, I think drawing the conclusion that the RO plant is the source is definitely more hand waving.
What does this data mean, you know, for people living in Cape Coral?
Well, I think that we all need to be very concerned with ground sinking in Florida because we do use a lot of water for irrigation, for drinking water, and our population is continuing to grow.
That expansion is being felt by residents all over the Cape.
Construction here has just gone crazy. I mean, it's good, but it's also bad in some respects. When we moved here 10 years ago, the traffic was bad, but nothing like it is now. And they're building houses on every empty lot just continually. And
the entire city isn't sinking in general.
To get a better idea of what's behind this sinking, we went to Dr. Tom Missimer, who actually helped the Cape develop its very first RO plant.
There are very specific areas that are sinking. Again, most of it's related to the instability of the soils. And those areas have been filled.
Missimer says it all stems from mistakes made more than 50 years ago when the Cape was first developed.
If you look at some of the roads up in North Cape Coral, they have dips in the roads and they've had to be filled on occasion. And there are other areas where lots have had to be filled. And again, it's the instability of the soils and how they were developed. The wetland soil should not have been put on the ground. They should have been separated and then it would have been stable.
When we talk about sinking, what are some of the short-term consequences and long-term consequences?
Well, one of the things, there's a limit to the amount of sinking that's going to occur in certain parts of North Cape Coral. It's not a general, citywide problem.
Although no alarm bells are going off at this point, Dr. Roth says this research should encourage action to assure the Cape is heading in the most sustainable direction.
We need to make sure that these plants and any kind of municipal pumping facilities, as well as our permitting offices, are doing hydrogeologic modeling to understand the sustainable quantity that we can pull out in a day. How many millions of gallons of water can we pull out in a day that gets naturally replenished by that groundwater that's flowing deep underground? Those kinds of studies need to be done on an annual basis so that we're checking to make sure that we're not taking more out of our water bank account than we're depositing into our water bank account.
In Cape Coral, Zuri Hoffman, NBC2.